Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will learn how to bind ExpandoObject and DynamicObject to Blazor DataGrid. Here, I'm going to continue with my existing Blazor WebAssembly example. So if you want to know how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion components to it, check the video link shown in the above YouTube card. And you can also find its reference link in the description part below. Now, I'll proceed to show you how to bind data to Blazor Data Grid using ExpandoObject binding. Before starting this video, first let me explain you what is ExpandoObject. The ExpandoObject is a class that allows you to add and delete the member of its instance at a runtime and also to set and get values of these members. Usually, Blazor Data Grid is strongly bound to a data source model type. Suppose you want to define the model type at runtime, then you can make use of this ExpandoObject class. Now, I'll show you the steps to bind the ExpandoObject to Data Grid. First, I'll open the existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component with the property DataSource to bind data and added grid columns stack to display and customize specific columns with properties like field, header text, text align, and width. Here I have bound orders data to Blazor Data Grid. See the output page now. The Blazor grid rendered with 4 columns: order ID, customer name, order date, and freight. Here, in this example, you can notice that all the 4 fields are already defined in the order model class and it acts as a data source type for Blazor Data Grid. Suppose if I would like to bind dynamic properties at runtime without defining the model class, then I may need to use ExpandoObject binding. Here, I'm going to use ExpandoObject class. So let me first remove the model class order and its reference from a fields property of Blazor Data Grid. To use this ExpandoObject, I need to import the namespace system.dynamic. And then I'll change grid data source type as ExpandoObject by changing the orders list type as ExpandoObject. Then I need to create a dynamic instance for ExpandoObject class. So within this onInitialized method, let me declare a variable DynamicObject of type dynamic and initialize it. Now, using this dynamic instance, I'll generate a dynamic object with ExpandoObject class and make a list by casting it as a list of ExpandoObject. Look at the output page now. The Blazor Data Grid component displayed with 4 dynamic data source properties: order ID, customer name, order date, and freight. Now, let me proceed to show you how to bind a dynamic object as data source for Blazor Data Grid. The dynamic object class enables you to define which operations can be performed on dynamic objects and how to perform those operations. I cannot directly create an instance of the dynamic object class. To implement the dynamic behavior, you may want to inherit from the dynamic object class and override these 3 methods: tryGetMember, trySetMember, and getDynamicMemberNames. So as a first step, let me define a class orderDetails and inherit the base class dynamic object. Then within this order details class, I'll define a variable orders dictionary of type dictionary to store key pair value of the dynamic properties. Next, I'm going to override 2 methods, tryGetMember and trySetMember, to specify dynamic operations on these properties. First, let me start to override the tryGetMember method, and this method will be called if we try to get the value of property which is not defined. Within this method, I get the value of a dynamic property through binder and I need to assign it to the string variable name. Then I will return this variable name to the orders dictionary using tryGetValue method. Here, if the property is found in the orders dictionary, then I will set the result parameter to property value and it returns true. Suppose if the property name is not found in the orders dictionary, then it returns false. Next, I'll start to override the trySetMember method, and this method will be called if we try to set the value of property which is not defined. Within this trySetMember method, I need to set the value of an undefined property. So I'll assign this object value to an undefined property in orders dictionary and it always returns true. And then I need to override the getDynamicMemberNames method and it returns the dynamic property name. Now I will change this orders list type as order details and create a dynamic instance for order detail class. Look at the output page now. You can see the data grid component displaying same orders data here. Here you can perform all kinds of supported data operations and editing using ExpandoObject and a dynamic object. Now let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. In this video, I showed you how to bind ExpandoObject and dynamic object to Blazor Data Grid. You can download this working example from the GitHub link shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community license guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.